Yeah, the pulpa means, so this is liquefied petroleum gas. Means, so when the hydrocarbons are subjected to liquefaction, so we will get LPG and CNG will get, means CNG is the compressed natural gas, we say coal gas. Now let me ask you one question. What are the components of LPG? What are the components of CNG? What are the components of coal gas? This is very important question for you. Sometimes in exams, in competitive
Sir, for
exams.
LPG, is it butane and propane?
LPG is made up of what are the components? Butane. Very good.
Propane.
Major component is butane. Second one is propane. Excellent. LPG so is made up of so what are the gases? Butane, propane in major proportion. Butane will be more and ethane also present. Ethane also present in this, but major proportion will be the butane, LPG. So this is a liquefied petroleum gas, we say. And if you see the CNG, what are the components of the CNG? CNG full form is compressed natural gas, we say. So what are the differences between LPG and CNG? LPG we use in the domestic purpose, right? LPG. And so we use the CNG in automobiles, CNG automobiles. You are aware of the CNG automobiles?
Yes, sir.
So what are the components in the CNG? What
Methane.
hydrocarbons? What hydrocarbons will be compressed?
Methane.
Very good.
Methane.
In this methane is present and propane also present. Propane and other one is butane also present. So butane, so CNG and LPG. So when the hydrocarbons means these means the hydrocarbons present in this. So hydrocarbons present in this will burn. Means the hydrocarbons undergoes combustion to produce. So what are those means? Carbon dioxide and a large amount of energy comes out. Large amount of energy comes out. Means, so the hydrocarbons present in the LPG and CNG, if they undergo combustion, they produce carbon dioxide and water and energy. So a lot of energy comes out. So, and hence hydrocarbons are used, where means in the name of fuels. LPG and CNG. Can anyone tell the components of the coal gas? Coal gas also fuel. What are the components of the coal gas?
Methane.
Methane, right? Coal gas is taken from the coal mines, right? Methane, hydrogen, and CO2. These are the mixtures of the coal gas. Coal gas obtained from the coal mines, right? So the coal mines mainly produces the major gas, methane. Coal gas, the major one is methane, we say, and it is mixed with the hydrogen and CO2 also. But calorifically, coal gas has less than the, so where means, than CNG and LPG. Okay, so hydrocarbons we use in our daily life, LPG, in the name of LPG, in the name of CNG in automobiles. And coal gas in industries also we use. And these fuels undergo combustion in the presence of oxygen and produces a lot of energy, more energy it can produce. The hydrocarbons will produce more energy. So due to this reason, we use them in the form of fuels in our day-to-day life. So what are the other uses of, apart from the fuels, so what other uses of these hydrocarbons? Where do we use these hydrocarbons? other than the fuel.
In paints?
Yeah, in the name of dyes, dyes preparation, matlab paint preparations we use, and one more, drugs preparation, drugs manufacturing we use, drugs manufacturing also we use, and one more major use of hydrocarbons is that in the preparation of polymers, in the manufacture of polymers, what are the polymers that are prepared from the hydrocarbons? For example, from ethane.
From ethene.
So we prepare polythene, polystyrene. So polythene, polystyrene, means these are the polymers. So polymers, we say polythene and polystyrene are made from the hydrocarbons only. Polymers manufacturing, hydrocarbons are used. Dyes and drugs manufacturing also. So here simply the hydrocarbons having indispensable relationship with human life. Without hydrocarbons, human life will become difficult. So hence we need to learn about hydrocarbons. Right, so after learning about their uses, means hydrocarbons uses in our day-to-day life, so next we should learn about classification of hydrocarbons. Classification of hydrocarbons. The hydrocarbons, so classified into two categories. One is what we can write means open chain hydrocarbons, cyclic chain hydrocarbons. Already we learned these open chain hydrocarbons and cyclic chain hydrocarbons. So the open chain hydrocarbons again classified into two categories: saturated hydrocarbons, unsaturated hydrocarbons. In open chain hydrocarbons are classified into open chain hydrocarbons in which carbon having the state chain like this. So in this open chain hydrocarbons, saturated hydrocarbons are present, unsaturated hydrocarbons are present. So how do you classify the hydrocarbons into saturated and unsaturated on what basis? Can you tell?
The carbon bonds.
Carbon and hydrogen chain.
So in saturated hydrocarbons, between carbon, there is a single bond. In unsaturated hydrocarbons, so in these hydrocarbons, between carbon, at least a double bond, at least one single triple bond. So if such compounds containing, means hydrocarbons containing at least single double bond between carbon, single triple bond between the carbon, they are said to be unsaturated. Matlab, so carbon valency not satisfied here. Got it? Carbon valency not, tetravalency not satisfied. And in this case, saturated hydrocarbons, carbon tetravalency is satisfied. So tell me, what are the saturated hydrocarbons examples? We can write, do we give example alkanes?
Yes.
So alkanes, around the carbon, so methane, if you take single covalent bonds, tetravalent valency satisfied. And if you take, so ethane, carbon valency completely satisfied, single bond, alkanes. So the what is the general formula for the alkanes? To write number of alkanes, series of alkanes. What is the general formula we use to write?
CnH2n.
So the formula is CnH2n plus 2 is the general formula for alkanes we write. So if you take n value is equal to 1, you'll get methane. If n value equal to 2, C2H6, you will get. N value is equal to 3, you'll get C3H8. N value 4 means butane, you'll get C4H10, and so on, you'll be getting alkanes. Saturated hydrocarbons will get And so second category, unsaturated hydrocarbons. If you take unsaturated hydrocarbons, what are those means? Alkenes and alkynes. See, alkenes are called paraffins, we say. Paraffins. So means, paraffins means, so these are the hydrocarbons having little affinity for the water molecules. Means, they are hydrophobic nature. Paraffin means, what is the meaning of the paraffin means? Paraffin means, para means little. So affinity means attraction. So little attraction for the water molecules. So most of these saturated hydrocarbons are, so what we write means, hydrophobic nature. What is the meaning of hydrophobic? What is the meaning of hydrophobic? Away from that water molecule. It means insoluble in the water. And if you see alkenes, alkenes are called olefins. Olefins, we say. So oil forming we call. And alkynes, so alkynes containing triple bond, C triple bond, at least a single one. And the general form of alkenes, if you write CnH2n, whereas the general form of alkynes will be CnH2n-2. And if you take, so n value 1, do you get any alkene if you take n value 1 alkene? Do you get any alkene if you take n value is equal to 1? If n is equal to 1, so CnH2n plus, so this is the formula, n is equal to 1 means C and H2, CH2. So CH2, does the CH will exist, CH2 will exist? Does the CH2 will exist? Is it possible?
No.
Not possible, yes, because only two bonds are present around the carbon, but carbon valency, tetravalency, so not possible, even it cannot make the double bond, so this is wrong. So CH2, not possible for the independent existence. Then N is equal to 2 if you take, so N is equal to C2H2H4. So this will, this is possible, this is called ethene. Ethene is possible or not? And C3H6, propene is possible or not? Propene. And C4H8, so butene is possible or not? So these are the alkenes, the general form of alkenes. So CnH2n. Unsaturated hydrocarbons, unsaturated hydrocarbons. So, and next one more unsaturated hydrocarbon. What are those means? CnH2n-2. These are called alkynes. Alkynes consisting of at least between carbon-carbon single triple bond. And here is simplest alkyne is ethyne. Means general formula, N is equal to, so see, N is equal to 2 means you will get ethyne. Ethyne you will get, is that methane is possible? Is there any methane?
No,
so methane,
sir.
Is not possible, only ethyne. So, and after that, next you will be getting, so what is the compound means? Propyne is possible. And next one is butane is possible. Butane is possible, and next one is CH3, CH2, CH2, C triple bond, CH is, so pentane is possible, butane is, propyne and ethyne. These are the, so unsaturated alkynes. Unsaturated alkynes, we say, so these are aliphatic compounds. Aliphatic compounds. Open chain compounds, straight chain compounds, we say. And next classification of hydrocarbons is said to be cyclic hydrocarbons. The cyclic hydrocarbons. So cyclic hydrocarbons are classified into two categories. So what we call means homocyclic. Homocyclic. Got it. And what are those? Next one is heterocyclic. Heterocyclic we say. What are the homocyclic compounds? Homocyclic compounds having aliphatic nature. And aliphatic nature are, so homocyclic compounds. Aliphatic homocyclic compounds. Aromatic homocyclic compounds. Aromatic, the homocyclic compounds, what are the homocyclic? How you name these homocyclic compounds? On what basis homocyclic we say?
In which the carbon chain is not interrupted by any other atom like oxygen, nitrogen, silicon.
And they show the aliphatic characters, right? So aliphatic, and for example, if you take, what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? Cyclopropane. So what is the name of this compound?
Cyclobutane.
So what is the name of this compound?
Cyclopentane.
Cyclopentane and cyclohexane. So all these, so made up of means with the same carbon chain, means carbon chain having that carbon chain is not interrupted with any other atoms other than the carbon atoms. So here cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclohexane and cyclopentane, so will exhibit the characteristic features of the aliphatic hydrocarbons, matlab paraffin characters, so aliphatic characters we say. So here in this carbon chain, so throughout the chain, carbon atoms are present and hydrogen atoms are present, homogeneous environment will be present. And if you see aromatic, so homocyclic compounds, if you take one is example, so is benzene, other one is example, so naphthalene, so anthracene, phenanthracene, so aromatic, so homocyclic compounds. So here, these are also cyclic compounds, and in these cyclic compounds, so these are not aliphatic, so these are not similar to the, so aliphatic, but these are dissimilar with the aliphatic hydrocarbons, so they have the aromaticity. So aromaticity means showing that characteristic smell they have, and so these are not alkenes, these will get the aromatic characters. Because so conjugated pi bonds are present in the ring. Conjugated pi bonds are present in the ring. So those conjugated pi bonds will show the special characters, aromatic characters we say. Example benzene, example naphthalene, example you can take phenanthracene, anthracene. So these are the aromatic cyclic compounds we say. Got it. And next, heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds, what are those means? So some are having that aliphatic characters, some will be having that means we can write what are those means. The heterocyclic compounds, so non-aromatic character, so and furan, right, example, and aromatic character means if you take pyridine, this is that pyridine, so this is a pyridine having that aromaticity, so this furan not having the aromaticity. Heterocyclic compounds with the non-aromatic character, heterocyclic compounds having the aromatic character. Pyridine example we can write. Pyridine, so furan is that non-aromatic compound. So this is a classification of hydrocarbons. So based on their carbon chain, based on their what we call means properties, this is the classification we can give. So we'll go for the detailed discussion of classification in the upcoming classes. And so now about hydrocarbons, will exhibit the fundamental character is said to be isomerism. Already we learned about isomerism. So what is the what isomerism? This hydrocarbons will exhibit saturated hydrocarbons. Means here the hydrocarbons we are going to discuss about is that alkanes. So saturated hydrocarbons we are going to discuss, and these alkanes exhibit isomerism. Can anyone tell what kind of isomerism shown by the alkanes? First of all, what is isomerism? Isomerism is compounds having same molecular formula showing different structural formula is said to be what we call isomerism. So alkanes exhibit, so what kind of isomerism? Can anyone tell what kind of isomerism they can exhibit?
Chain isomerism.
Very good. Chain isomerism they exhibit. So what is a chain isomerism? So compounds having the same molecular formula and arrangement of the carbon atoms will be differs, right? That is a chain isomerism. So example, if you take C4H10, what is the name of this compound? Butane. The butane exists in the nature how many forms? So CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, this is a normal butane, and other one is CH3, CHO, CH3, CH2, this is that isobutane. So butane can exhibit two isomers. One is normal butane, other one is isobutane. 2-methylpropane. So what is the IUPAC name of second one? 2-methylpropane. First one is the normal butane. If you take C5H10, C5H12, what's the name of this compound? Pentane. So for the pentane, how many isomers are possible? Chain isomers are possible. Can you write? For the pentane, how many chain isomers do you get? One is normal pentane, right? Second one is, are you listening? Methyl butane, means which is otherwise called isopentane. Third one is, what is the third one?
3-methylbutane.
3-methylbutane is not possible.
Methylpropane.
Third isomer of pentane, what is that? You learned in 10th class also.
Dimethylpropane.
Yeah, so this is called neopentane. Can we write? Is it neopentane? Yes. Neopentane, yes, is the so third isomer. And similarly, if you write the chain isomers of C6H14, how many isomers are possible? Can you write now? Possible isomers of hexane. For hexane, how many isomers are possible?
It's 5.
5 isomers are possible. So normal hexane. So CH3, CH2, CH2. CH2, CH3, normal hexane. Second one is CH3. What is the IUPAC name of this second one?
Two methyl pentane.
Third isomer, CH3, CH2, CH3. थर्ड आइसोमर
सो थ्री मिथाइल पेंटेन
सो फोर्थ वन इज फोर्थ वन
सर 2.2 डाइमिथाइल ब्यूटेन
एंड फोर्थ वन फिफ्थ नेक्स्ट वन इज सो नेक्स्ट फिफ्थ आइसोमर
सर बोर्ड इज नॉट कंप्लीटली विजिबल
सर आई गेस इट्स 2.3 डाइमिथाइल
3.3
ब्यूटेन
3.3 सी फोर कार्बन्स राइट हियर इज वन
सर
कार्बन एटम्स आर अरेंज्ड 2.3 डाइमिथाइल ब्यूटेन
यस सर
सो नंबर ऑफ आइसोमर्स हाउ मेनी आर पॉसिबल फॉर द हेक्सेन
Five isomers.
Five. If you take heptane, number of isomers will increase 9. And if it obtain means 13, so number of isomers will increase as if you write systematically. So here the isomerism is a phenomenon of the hydrocarbons or organic compounds. So having the same molecular formula. And exhibiting different structural formula. The different structural formula compounds are said to be isomers. So what is the similarity of isomers? What is the dissimilarity of isomers? In terms of properties. Isomers will have the same molecular formula. So what will be the difference? What difference do you notice? Isomers to each other in terms of properties. Do they have the same chemical properties or do they have the same chemical properties?
No, sir.
They do not have the same chemical properties. Composition is same, no?
Yes, sir. Molecular formula is same.
Molecular formula is same, same number of carbon atoms, same number of hydrogen atoms. If the composition is the same, means they should have the same chemical properties, no? Same chemical properties are not.
Properties and different physical property.
Yeah, they have different physical. Example, can you give example?
Boiling point.
Melting points and boiling points differs. For example, if you take normal butane if you take, and isobutane if you take, isobutane will take, tell me out of these two, one and two, which one has more boiling point, which one has less boiling point? Which one has more boiling point, which one has less boiling point? These are the two isomers of butane, no?
The second one.
Second one has high.
So less.
Less. So what is the reason? If a number of chains increases on the means in that compound, so branches increases in the hydrocarbon, boiling point decreases. So and for the straight chain compounds, so boiling point will be more. The reason is in the straight chain compound, van der Waal forces will be strong. In the branched one is van der Waal forces are weak. So straight chain compounds easily will make bulk, but branched one due to that weak van der Waal forces, we cannot make that bulk, right? So these are the reasons. So isomers, two different isomers that having same molecular formula, so they differ in terms of physical properties. and they have the same chemical properties, we can say. Now, I'm giving one example. This is C5, pentane formula is molecular formula C5H12 or H14?
Pentane C5H12.
Yeah, now if I write C5H11, what's the name of this compound?
Pentyl.
Pentyl. So, can you write the pentyl isomers? So how many chain isomers? One, two, number of carbons. So to this pentyl, what I am doing, I am attaching one OH functional group. OH functional group. Can you write the, means what kind of chain isomerism this pentyl alcohol, means this pentanol will exist, will show. What type of isomerism? Position isomerism?
Yes, sir.
So, how many the position isomers? So, do you get this pentanol? Can you write now? Write the IUPAC names of these pentyl alcohol, this pentanol. Can you write the isomers? First one is, so I wrote, this is so pentanol. Second one. Can I write, can I place the OH group here? What is the second one? IUPAC, write the IUPAC name.
Pentane 2-ol.
So, is can you place the OH group on the third carbon? Pentane 3-ol is possible?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
so, sir. So, pentane 1-ol, pentane 2-ol, pentane 3-ol. Can you write one more?
Yes, sir.
Dipali.
No, sir.
So, can I write here OH? What is the name of this compound?
Methyl butane 2-ol.
So, is it isomer? Does it make any sense? Is it isomer? Tell me. Is it possible? Next compound. So you may get a number of isomers of pentanol, 8 isomers you'll get. How many you'll get? 8 isomers. How many we write? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 3 more also possible. You can write 3 more. Here is 1 more. Is it possible, next one? You can keep on writing the position isomers of pentanol. So you'll get, there are 8 isomers of pentanol you'll be getting. Okay, so you can try. So writing this isomers. I think time up. Okay, so just this is the introduction to hydrocarbons. And tomorrow, so we'll discuss the preparation methods of hydrocarbons. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.